So hey Brainiacs, welcome back. So today we will be doing the next part, that is the organizing files. So the first project, which is a in-house project, basically it's explained in the book. It is renaming files with American style dates to European style dates. So I'll not take much of a time here. We will just put the MMDD YYY format to DDMM YYY format. So what the program will do is it will search for all the file names in the current working directory, which will be having the American style dates. And when the file is formed, the file name will be swapped. Okay, and the basically file name will be swapped along with the new data. So this we'll be doing, and for that, what is going on here, I will let you know in a program directly, so that you don't have to go through all those words. And I'll be keeping this one here so that I can tell you what exactly this one will be pointing to. So let's start. So if you can see, what we'll be doing for that is we will be importing the shuttle OS and RE libraries, and we will be having a date pattern regular expression matching that will be having the dot. It will be starting with the caret and then dot star question mark. That means it should start with some letter, some word before the dates. And then we will be doing the 01. That means the day, the month should either be starting with a 0 or a 1. And in this scenario, it will cover 1-2 also for December and 0-2 also for the month of February. Same like this thing, it will be taking the 1 or 2 digits for the day. That means it should contain 0, 1, 2, 3, and then question mark it, and anything it can be contained. And same thing for the 4 digits for next year, for whatever year is there. So we are not thinking about 1820, because we know from 19th century onwards the main computer part filing and all process is there. And so just to make our programs little bit error free for most of the time, we know there will be many document which will get filtered out because of the not pattern matching. But I think as long as we need, most of the files will be processed except the dates in February or something. And after that, it will be the same thing. That means that if we did a caret, we will do a dollar here, that whatever text after the date is there, we will be matching those two. So then we will just iterate over the current directory. And we will be checking the date parameter pattern search MR file name. If the parameter has returned nothing, so we will be doing the next, going to the next file. Or if else, if it's there inside, if here it's not gone, we will be going to before part. So if you see, the before part will get the group 1, month will get group 2, day part will be having 4, year part will be having 6, after part will be having 8. For this one, now let me explain you here. So the date pattern, it will go the first as a, all the text before the date, and then 2 and 3 will be having the digits of the month, 4 and 5 might contain the day, and 6, 7 will contain the year, and 8 will contain the text. That's the reason why we will be having this. Okay, and how will we matching? We'll be matching the before part, then day part, then month part, then year part, and then after part. And then we will be getting the absolute part, basically the current working directory. We can put any other directory also if you want. And we will be doing the same path join for both of them. And the file name will be Euro file name. And if you see, Euro file name is definitely here, which will be having the same thing. And right now I'm printing it only. So because as in the book, it's mentioned to do any changes, which will be a permanent change. First try to print it with pretty printing to see actually you are doing the right thing or not, and then go for the change. So let's just see what actually will do. Let's run the program. So see, my program has run. It will give me this thing that there. Oh, okay, sorry. So here is my thing, that the previous questions and previous solutions we have tried have been taking the same thing. If you see capital quiz, it's in date, in basically American date format, same as goes here, and same goes for the Madlibs. Now I will be, I tried to run the program. It told me that it will be renaming the, as I have put a slash n after and before 2 and after renaming also. So if you see, it will be doing like this. If you see, it goes here to here and here to here. That's your American date format. This is your European date format. So now what I'll be doing is I will be uncommenting this shuttle.move. So in this way it will give me the correct date now. It has done it. Let's see what we got. So if you see, everything is changed now. So yeah, this is what we actually have to do. And then in the book it's saying that we can also start a prefix for the start of the file name, such as add spam underscore to rename x dot. So if you want, you can just put this thing also, like if I want, I can put this spam underscore this, okay, or I can just reverse it and just try to do it, okay. So this will be done. And then to change the file names in European style dates to American style dates, we can do the reverse right now. Here we just have to switch this to that and this to this, and that's it. Then basically to change the file name is then to remove the zeros from the file, such as spam 0049042. This is the actual thing where you have to get the digits, and this will be done with a regex compile. You know that you have to replace it with nothing, which using a sub functionality, or else you can loop over character array, everything, anything you can do. So this is what it was, and now let's we will be moving to the next program. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this video. Let's do the next program in the next video. Thank you.